Hello students, you are welcome on nursing tutorial. Today we are going to discuss about the topic of computer assisted learning. This topic belongs to nursing education for MSc nursing students. So we have to discuss about the introduction of computer assisted learning. It is e-learning. The way a person learns and communicates electronically is emerging as a key application of the internet. Is emerging. Emerging means it is a noticeable. E-learning covers a wide set of applications and processes such as web-based learning, computer-based learning, and virtual classrooms. Virtual classroom means the classroom which are not physically present, only present in the digital area, and digital collaboration. Digital collaboration is to bring all resources together so that information can be easily shared and ideas can be easily synthesized. Okay, then the definition of computer assisted learning. Computer assisted learning is to convey a vast amount of information in a very short period of time. It is powerful of reinforcing concept. Reinforcing concept means strengthening the concepts. Concept means idea. And topics first introduced to students through textbook and discussion in the classroom. Computer assist learning enables in a powerful way to comprehend complex concept. And this, the first of all, provide the knowledge to the students regarding computer assisted learning in the classroom. After that, they use the computer so that they can easily comprehend, easily understand about the complex concepts, complex ideas. It refers to anything delivered, enabled, or mediated by electronic technology for the explicit purpose of learning. Then types of computer assisted learning. There are two types. Computer assisted instructions, which we already discussed. When computer is used as an aid to teaching method of instruction, it is called computer assisted instruction. Then computer managed instruction. It is defined as the use of computer programs for the online management of the instructional process. Then next is models of computer assisted learning. There is a drill and practice mode, means the already individual know something, some learning they have, some knowledge they have, they apply continuously and side by side learning new things. Then tutorial methods, laboratory mode, case simulation mode, and consultant role. Purposes of computer assisted learning. It supports educational and organizational goals, improved training cost, decreased material cost, increased productivity, standardization, decreased material cost. How? Because computer have a soft copy. Then there is no need for hard copy. Then improved training cost, because with the help of one virtual classroom, there are, we can teach many students and we can improve the training cost. Then it supports the learner's development, real-time access, freedom to fail or pass, improved retention. Improved retention means according to the availability of the time, everyone gives some time to for computer learning and something other with the help of computer they can learn. Personalized learning nurtures a learning organization and community. What do you mean by nurture? It encourages the learning, encourages or improved the condition of the organization and the community, ongoing access to resources, knowledge management, encourage sharing, and learner's choice. According to the learner choice, there are information available. Then classroom e-learning technology. Classroom e-learning technology in classroom e-learning, it refers to the devices like software, hardware, in the classroom we have to use. Then internet technology, web technology. In web technology, Web technology refers to the languages of the computer. Like various kind of languages are there: JavaScript, HTML, CSS, WordPress, PHP. There are various kind, and it usually refers to the means by which computer communicate with each other using these kind of languages. Then digital learning resources. Digital learning resources, those material already in the digital format like audio, video, animations and simulation. Then computer mediated communication, it refers to human communication by using the computer in the form of exchange, text messages, images, audios and videos. Okay, then digital learning resources, this include placing Word document on the web for students to download and print, or making PowerPoint presentation available after lecture to create web pages that make use of the media to create web pages that make use of the media to stream the digital video and simple interactive CAL like program, computer assisted program. Then next is advantages of computer assisted learning. Each student receives instruction at his own pace according to the capability. Students can learn, receives the knowledge or instruction. Each student responds continuously as he receives instruction. All units learning are broken down into subunits and small elements of the learning so that the students can easily catch the material. Students can access the computer at any place. Students can learn through their own ways and style, through examples, through case studies, and through problem solving. Then students can test their learning at any time of progress. The computer is consistent. Consistent means continue the process, which is continuation. Then relevant means the information or the learning that is authentic and approving of every student. The program author can update a computer lesson as a new knowledge is identified. Then there are some disadvantages of computer assisted learning. What are that? Cost factors, because some students not afford the cost of computer learning. Then content control, because there are huge number of resources provided the content. Lack of format, communication among user with excessive use of computer assisted learning. Artistic competence of students takes a backseat, because when the students always learning from the computer, then there is a individual one-to-one basis learning, and there is no class, no competition, no, then the talent of the students comes outside. Then it produces more mental and physical stress as compared to other methods of teaching, because it needs sitting in front of computer. It does not help in developing language proficiency, which depends more on direct experience with the reality, because the computer do not talk with us. They provide only instruction or correct our instruction. Like our teacher, it do not communicate with us. As students cannot interact with the computers is in a human language, the mechanical response by punching keys can become dull and frustrating. Okay? That's why when we use computer for a long time, feel exhaust. Then computer mediated communication. These includes email, the most popular internet tool used for exchange messages between individuals. I think everyone have this facility in today's world. Mailing list, it uses to enable communication among groups of people. We can see from where I received the mail, to whom I send the mail. Individuals send emails to list mail address and receive a copy of all emails sent to that address. Then computer conferencing, it enables group of people to Hold a discussion by reading and posting text messages on computer system. Then the next is video conferencing, a means by a small group of geographical distant people can hold a discussion at real time during which they are able to hear and see each other. For example, web with the help of Skype. These days it is a very popular method in for online classes. Teachers sitting in Jalandhar city and our students sitting everywhere in Punjab, and our students teach and talk with the students. Hybrid systems such as a web board combined threaded discussion list, IRC. What does it mean, IRC? Internet Relay Chat, which we have done in the form of online chatting. Emails lists allow users to switch between the people depending on the nature of discussion. It also offers facility to share documents and images. Conclusion of the topic, that is computer assisted learning. Technology results in new designs and devices, as also new ideas and process. Educational technology is the application of the scientific knowledge in a systematic way to improve the efficiency of the process of learning and instruction. It is considered as the technology of education more than technology in education. Actually, day by day, new devices, new innovation, new software comes to improve the learning facility. I hope you have cleared this topic. If you feel any kind of problem in this topic, kindly inform me. I feel very happy to help you. Thank you very much. Have a nice day. Take care.